give you mine, but to my phone number 207-975-9659. You'll wonder, why is this guy not getting back to me? My phone has been dead for like 3 or 4 days. I think I need to put it in a tomb somewhere. So anyway, back on the table, and I saw we look like bulletins. Are you kidding me? We have bulletins now? We're getting too professional. So anyway, but we just want to welcome you. We're grateful that you're here. And if you're looking to connect, just let us know. We want to start small groups up and just plug you in as we can. We do have a Wednesday night Bible study that meets right now on Depot Street. So if you're interested in that, let us know. But we do want to get more things going on. So we're blessed today. We're going to be serving communion. And Joe and Carly are going to be serving. So let's take just a moment before the Lord and prepare our hearts. We know that the scripture says that we should examine ourselves before we eat and drink of the body and the bread, remembering what our Lord and Savior did for us on the cross. And so when we eat the bread, we're remembering his body was broken for us. When we drink the cup, we're remembering that it was his precious and divine blood that was shed on that cross for the remission, for the forgiveness, the taking away of sin. So Paul says, you know, don't do that lightly. And so we know that this is a celebration for the believer. So if you're a believer today, we invite you to receive communion. If you're not a believer, we just encourage you to put your trust in the Lord Jesus Christ, who came to save sinners. And the scripture says that whosoever will call upon the name of the Lord will be saved. So Lord, we ask that you would search our hearts now. As we prepare, Lord, for communion, we thank you, Lord, that you provided the only way for us to be forgiven through your death and your resurrection. As Peter said, there is no other name given under heaven whereby we must be saved. And we know, Lord Jesus, as you said very clearly, you said, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No one comes to the Father but through me. So, Lord Jesus, we know you are the only way. And so we celebrate you today. And we pray that you'll forgive us of all of our sins of this week. We ask that you cleanse our hearts, purify our minds, Lord, and enable us to receive this as a celebration today. And we pray this in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. we were living in the Old Testament times, and you had to bring an animal to be sacrificed for your sin. And we knew it was just a covering, that it didn't really take it away, but it was when God required. Imagine that every time that you sinned, and then for the Israelites, once a year, the Day of Atonement. So you probably would think, boy, when I sin, something's going to have to die. So when you look at the bread, think that your Lord and Savior took your punishment on the cross. He had to die for you to be forgiven. So Jesus said, do this when you eat the bread, remember to me.
Thank you.
so many churches being in shopping malls or looking like corporate centers, you don't often see a cemetery, do you, near a church? They did this for a reason, I think. It's a good reminder that we're all going to end up there one day, right? It's going to be a plaque with your name on it, unless we take it up in the rapture, right? But think about that. This is such a celebration because the blood of Jesus Christ takes away your sins, and you will pass from judgment into life. Isn't that a blessing? Yeah. So as we receive today, remember, Paul said, quoting Jesus, this is the new covenant in my blood. Whenever you eat this bread and drink this cup, you proclaim the Lord's death until he comes.
Yeah. Thank you. sins. Lord, you shed your precious blood to cover those sins. And Lord, as we go out from this place today, may we take that message to the world. Yes. And for somebody in here today, Lord, that doesn't know that, if what they've just heard this morning doesn't pierce their hearts, Lord, I don't know what will. So may your Holy Spirit be upon us today. Thank you for Pastor Shoes. Lord, we just thank you for his wife and his daughter. Thank you for the message that they brought here last night. Lord, there was a small revival right here on the Dutch Ditch Road. Lord, it's still reviving me. I know that, Lord. I thank you for that. Lord, just be with us this day. We love you, Lord. We praise your holy name. In your name, the Son of Jesus Christ. Amen.
Amen.